We're going to now discuss this idea of a drug space or molecular space. And I'd say one of our main goals is to appreciate just how huge drug space is, how just the incredible diversity of molecules that can be potentially sampled in order to find drugs. On the screen is a box. This box represents all the different molecules that could be considered as drugs, or drug-like molecules. This box represents a molecular space. How many drug-like molecules could fit inside this box? Well, nobody knows. An estimate for the number of molecules, drug-like molecules, is 10 to the 62nd power. That's actually more molecules than there are atoms in our solar system. It's just a mind-blowingly huge number. So the diversity of molecules that can be considered for drugs is huge. All right, well, what are the properties that we can find in drug-like molecules? Well, definitions vary, but oral drugs normally contain about 30 heavy atoms. What is a heavy atom? These are non-hydrogen atoms. For the most part, for drugs, we're talking about carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, the halogens, that's fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine, and for good measure, we'll throw in sulfur and phosphorus. Let's see some example drug spaces. Let's say we're looking for a heart disease drug. Within this drug-like space, most of the space will be empty. These molecules won't be suitable to treat heart disease. But we will find little areas of molecules with weak activity, hit-like activity. Let's draw a couple. And within these hit regions, we'll find more promising molecules. And these might be leads. And then finally, even subregions where we might find drugs. Let's put some leads down here and some drug space as well. If we were instead to look at an obesity drug, we might find that these are our hit spaces. And within those hit spaces, we have some lead regions and, of course, some drugs and some leads over here. Maybe no drugs over there. So if we look at these spaces, they are different. These spaces don't overlap between heart disease and obesity. It's because these two conditions would have different targets, and drugs that bind different targets are going to show up in different spaces in this overall drug space. The point of these diagrams is to show that the number of potential drugs is vast. I've drawn these areas of hits, leads, and drugs way too large. Finding a drug within this drug-like space is truly a needle in a haystack problem. There is good news, however. Drug-like spaces contain more than one potential drug. In fact, there might be millions or billions of drugs for each disease within the vastness of drug space. The job of a drug company is not to discover the best single molecule. The job instead is to find one of the many safe and effective molecules. We've now introduced this idea of drug spaces, and this is a really useful way to think about how we search for drugs, almost as a contour plot, as we search for drugs that have molecules that have weak activity, better activity, and then drug-like activity.